All right, turning to the tree keepers discussion, the tree keeping fund, all of that being, you know, just creating jobs, creating work careers for college minded individuals to take the vocation direction of, to fall out of college and actually have a career for the rest of their lives. So that, good, but also things that we have to include in that office, because it's going to be a new set of offices there. We need map keeping of historical. Now, when I say map keeping historical, we have to have a development master plan, a guideline from what we are really trying to recreate here. When I'm looking at a recreation, I'm trying to go back to when it was simply a Polynesian sailor in a tiny little raft, a tiny canoe that was able to sail from the Polynesian islands directly here to the shores of the United States without a problem, with no big interruptions. We're talking about bringing back those smooth sailings, the smooth time of the seas. Since we've been here, we've just created turmoils. More and more turmoils with all of this interruption and derogatory clear cuttings. You know, we've interrupted the flow of wind. We've interrupted the flow patterns. We've interrupted the way the seas are maintained by the wind. We have overdone it. I won't say we any longer. Gosh dang it! I got to get that out of my sentence structure. But when I get to, we need the maps from those histories. I don't want just 100 years ago. I want 2,000 years ago. I want 3,000 years ago. What was happening on your coastline? That is relevant. That is a relevant reconstruction. What was really going on? What type of trees? What can be brought back? What was it? Was there a tree that was there, that was indigenous? Can we bring it back to the region? If it's been threatened, if it's been endangered in that particular zone, can we get that tree right back there again? So we have to get to the historical stats before the huge population uprise, before the coasts were just obliterated. We have to get back to the time where it was forest veldt coastlands, even for beautiful little Ireland. Even beautiful little Ireland, bring it back. Bring it back away from the wasteland of wind that they have created. Bring it back to its beautiful island that it's supposed to be. I know the trees grow there. I live there. I know they grow there. I know forests grow there. It's just been an obliteration of human beings that destroyed it. So if we go back to 3,000 years ago, let's use those maps, let's use those historians, let's bring them into the picture of this master plan. And this is all coastlines all around the world. But obviously right now I'm in this California area. I can only really talk about California specifically in this situation, but this has to go on everywhere. It has to go on everywhere. I have to do this in France, especially also for filtration. We talk about we want clean oysters out there and mussels. On the seabeds raised in France, well, they have taken the trees. And so by taking the trees, you don't get the filters that can help back into the water that clean out those mussels. So if you want clean sea fish, you're going to have to put those trees back. Okay, it's all part of the ecosystem. Alright, Dantaria, a reconstruction of reconstruction of the historicals 2 to 3,000 years ago, and I believe we will find a real substantial truth of what we were supposed to look like, what these coastlines were supposed to look like, okay, before the interruption of massive populace. Now we can live, massive populations can live with forests. We can absolutely live with forests near, around, and nearby. There's no reason to obliterate them. It's just the way we've lazily chosen our housing choices. All right. So anyway, we need the reconstruction mapping system back then. And all of this will be useful guidelines for any of our tree keepers that work for the tree keeping fund and are paid through that. Okay.